If you haven't turned on your swag this morning, what are you doing? Hi my GYs, welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's your girl Gomi, back with the whole shebang, back with another video. I hope you're all doing well. If you haven't turned on your swag this morning, what are you doing? I need you to turn on your swag. Look into the mirror and say, what's up? And say, I'm getting money.
Oh, I know about the beard, turn my swag on. Took a look in the mirror, said, what's up?
Turn my swag on. I'm getting money. Welcome to all the new subscribers. We made it to 200.
I'm so heavy. Perfect. I'm so heavy.
To everybody who's been supporting my channel, appreciate that love. Of course, it's a vlog. It's a road trip type thing, you know. Celebrate the festive season. We're going on a little road trip to Inuit, and I'm gonna be vlogging the experience for you guys. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this video. If you haven't subscribed already, I need you to subscribe right now. Switch on the notification button, like, comment, and share with your family and friends. Okay. I would really appreciate it. So many exciting videos to come. Exciting content that's on the way in 2024. Like, y'all ain't ready, so let's get the subscribers up. Okay, but anyways, without further ado, let's get into it.
So just after we left home, we decided to get some pizza for the road so that, you know, we'd be satisfied and all of that.
I'm starting.
I'm legally blind.
So guys, we are here in Masasa. We're getting some pizza or whatever to give, you know, the vibe, the start.
So at this point, we were deciding what to order, and we decided to get a triple stack pizza. Well, two of them, the meat deluxe and chicken and mushroom. Look at how tantalizing that looks. Too good and tasted so good. Then we made our way to Imire, and you know, it's meant to be a 2-hour drive, but my mom drives like we have 9 lives, so we made it there in like 1:30 or less, I think. But yeah, it was quite a wholesome drive to the place. We finally arrived and super excited. I was so happy the weather was withering the way it was supposed to wither, because the rains were a no-no for me. Then, you know, we were just talking to the person who was supposed to help us out, trying to understand what activities we had to do. And then this is just a view of the entrance, Nyana, guys. Like, it's so pretty. It's such a beautiful place. If you want to relax, this is the place to go. It is very peaceful and quiet. And like, and all that wild stuff, you know. So, yeah.
So this is a little like room tour. This is my mom's room. It's a very nice place actually. And thanks to me, because I'm the one who made the booking, I chose the rooms. So, you know. Yeah, of course, I have good taste. Okay, so this is the room for my sisters and I. It's very, very cute. This is the bathroom. Very clean.
Okay, yeah, so this is upstairs in our room. Twin beds. So that's where my little sister and I are gonna be chilling. And yeah, it's pretty cute. I really, really like the vibe.
This was just me showing you the common area from a different angle. Like I see it, it's very, very beautiful, very pretty, and very worth it.
So this is, I guess, the dining area. Yeah, it's quite cozy.
So, time for the elephant walk, rhino feeding, and sunset drive all in one. Let's go, let's get it, let's have a great time. Look at me feeding the elephant, guys. His name is Mark. He's such a cutie, and that's his wife in the back, Monday Boo. And then guess what? They were like, oh my gosh, the elephant is gonna do a trick for you. Wear a hat. And then it ate the hat. It took off the hat from my head. And I was like, oh my gosh, this is insane. What the hell? Then they were like, okay, so to ask it back, you literally have to beg the elephant. So I got down on my knees, like how some of you will be begging to get back together with your exes, cunty. That's a story for another day. I was like, please, Marky, like, can I have this head back? It's not even mine. Like, hey, I was like looking into its eyes, and then it was like, okay, well, I'll give you your head back. And I was like, oh my god, thank you, babe. But yeah, and then I had to like feed it again afterwards. And nobody taught this elephant how to do the trick on its own. Like, it literally just does it on its own, and that's how intelligent this animal is. That was pretty cool. So Rainbow said she would be a sloth if she were an animal. Because sloths are so chilled, they don't have stress. No, I'll Next up, we had rhino feeding, and the guide was just explaining how to feed the rhino. Her name is Shanu, and then I did the feeding. I was scared because I didn't want it to like grab my hand and like bite my fingers off, so I just kind of like threw it, and I was like, yeah, I'll get somebody else to do it. But it was pretty cool seeing them up close and also understanding how dangerous they can be. The last thing for that day was the sunset drive. We just drove to a nice spot by the river where we could see the sun setting, and it was so, so beautiful. Such a lovely atmosphere. And yeah, my sister's being silly as usual. Anyways, so yeah, the sun was coming out, and like we went up the, I don't know what it's called, yeah, up this structure, and we really saw the sun setting very nicely, and it was just very peaceful, quiet, and yeah, quite pretty as well. So this is the last thing that we've done for the day. So I really, really enjoyed it. I had such a great time. You know, it was really wholesome, and just seeing how beautiful Zim is, well, at least this side of Zim, and it's quite refreshing, and just the peace and quiet is just very like much needed. So you know, that connection, Yana, with nature, exactly. But yeah, so this is the end of today's what, Christmas Eve, exactly. That's basically it. Sun is, but anyway, some kids, what, you know what I'm saying? And then we had dinner. These were chicken breasts and mashed potatoes. And then for dessert, we had chocolate tarts. And yeah, their food is pretty good. Hi my G-Wagon, so Merry Christmas, Merry Chrysler. Today we've got a game drive that's been planned. I think that's what we're gonna do today, I'm not sure what else, but yeah. I hope you enjoy what's about to come. Guys, look at how huge my food baby was. Like, I was literally about to burst, like my, like you guys. Anyways, time for the game drive. The weather was actually so favorable considering that it was Christmas, and usually it rains on Christmas Day, so that was nice.
From the Save River, where he killed more than 5 schoolboys, a lot of cows, a lot of goats and sheep, and perhaps even more people. So what happened was, like, these kids used to cross the stream, I mean, and the water was close to waist deep, and every time he would ambush those boys and take them down and eat them. And the villagers were so furious that they wanted to kill him, but then National Parks offered to give him to anyone who would want to look after him. So Norman Travers And I'm telling you, that was in 1975 when this thing happened. He's close to 90 years of age.
Wow.
He's like 100, 110, 120 years. That's their lifespan.
Wow.
So, and you know, they say that the older the predator, the more experience it has in terms of killing. So Crispin was killing those. So when he got here, I'm sure he did have a chat with Margaret. It's like, you know, girl, I did some things terrible there in the past. I mean, but you know, when telling women things, I mean, see what you can say. I'm sure he didn't understand it, and then he just spilled it all out. And Margaret was like, oh my gosh, the next thing, this guy is gonna eat me. And obviously, maybe that's when she decided to pick her things and leave Crispin. And poor Crispin now is all by himself. And I guess he's just gonna live by himself.
So guys, let me tell you a funny story about these zebras and donkeys. So these two donkeys are boys and those two zebras are girls. And these donkeys, I forgot how they came into the park, okay? But they were like, ha, dude, we can't spend the rest of our lives starving. We need, like, my baby. We need some honeys, you know? And, like, we got these zebras at our disposal. So one of the donkeys was like, oh, you know what, ZB, like, you know, I got you, like, I can be the one for you, I can be your soulmate, let's do our thing. And then they gave birth to a zonkey. I promise you guys, I'm not joking. They gave birth to a zonkey. It would have been so cool to see the zonkey, but unfortunately, the zonkey got eaten by one of the predators. I don't quite remember which one, but yeah, ish, shame, guys. Anyways, the next thing was seeing the one lion that's like near it. It's called Mambo, guys, and you're like, that animal's just so majestic, too majestic. And like, when it looks at you, it looks into your soul. Like, most of you are staying in competition, because yeah, it will be looking into your soul. And it was just so amazing to like see it, because usually like it might not be visible, but we got to see it. Next, we saw some giraffes. I think we saw about 5 in the spot. And guys, look at the way it's eating. Like, girl, aren't you gonna break your bag? Like, why are you standing like that? Shame, I feel so sorry for it. But yeah, that's how they eat. And giraffes are just generally beautiful animals. They're too pretty to be going through this. I mean, like, come on. Look, you're gonna break your spine or your neck or just everything. Like, hello. But yeah, it was pretty cool to see them. And they only have one male that we saw, and then the rest were females. So yeah, that was also nice. Next up, we got to see a rhino and its baby. So Tafika's the mom and Mudiwa's the baby rhino. I think these were white rhinos, black rhinos, I don't quite remember. But yeah, and then there was just this bush, Begana Pumba, over in Lion King. Waninge wangori kwese kwese, wachingo akira my situation. See, like some of y'all. But hey, that's a story for another day. But it was very wholesome to see a baby rhino and its mommy. Like, that was very cute. So these were the white rhinos. The white rhinos have wide lips. Yeah, so we got to see the ones I previously spoke about, the baby and the mom. Those were black rhinos. So these were white rhinos. Yeah, these are a family. So yeah, they were just like explaining to us how they got the name and all their jazz. And then afterwards, we had lunch by the river, you know, just, you know, take a break and relax. The last animals we saw were the buffaloes, which are part of the big 5. And yeah, it was very, very cool to see them. They're not as big, but yeah, those were the last animals that we saw. And yeah, that was pretty much the end of the game drive. Then at dinner, of course, we got Christmas crackers to pop open. So I opened mine with my mom. And guess what I got, guys? Guess what I got? Let me show you what I got. I got this. I'm gonna be like David, guys. You know, David and Goliath, he had the slingshot and the stones. And yeah, if anyone tries to provoke me, watch out, because I will come for you. Then they gave us a joke. The joke says, how do you keep cool in a football match? Sit next to a fan. Like, oh my gosh, that's so corny, but it was also funny at the same time. But yeah, that's literally how we ended the night last night.
Hi, my G1.
G-Wagons, thank you so much for watching my video. I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed making it. This is the end of the vlog. How much would I rate my experience here? I rate it a solid 8 out of 10, simply because, first of all, it's very beautiful, very peaceful, very quiet, and they actually have quite a number of animals that you can see. The only downside would be like maybe they should incorporate like more activities and stuff, but besides that, like I had a great time. It was quite refreshing and just, you know, like a nice change of scenery for a little bit. So I highly recommend you come here. Don't come for me. I know I'm in my bonnet, which means what's under there is scary, but maintenance week is on a threat. But yeah, thank you so much for watching, guys. If you haven't subscribed already, please do it right now. Switch on the notification button, help a girl out. We've just made it to 200 and the only way is up from here. No stopping, no going back. Okay, so make sure you like, comment and share with your family and friends, and stay tuned for more content. Bye.